I know I usually don't do an episode on the weekends, but I'm making a special exception with everything that's going on and many, if not all, in the community having their day-to-day lives change. So today I want to quickly share a few tips to help you get some stability and get an idea of how the two of you can shift and reprioritize things so that you can ride out the tough times that come ahead. Welcome to Couple Money, a podcast focused on helping spouses get on the same page, dump their debt faster, and get on the path to financial freedom together. I'm your host, Elle Martinez. This podcast is brought to you by Coastal Credit Union. Coastal's mission is to help you live a better life by offering you a better way to bank. Learn how by visiting bankbetter.org. I hope you are doing well and staying healthy. It is insane how much of a difference 1 week makes. First off, let's talk about financial priorities. Right now, I've gotten some emails from some of you in the community where you are living paycheck to paycheck, and with hours being cut or you're having to work at home, the question is, what do I pay first? Who's the most important? And I just want, as a reminder, have that foundation. Make sure that you're taking those essential expenses like your rent or mortgage, take care of the food, utilities, and transportation. When your budget is tight or uncertain, it's absolutely crucial to make sure you have that foundation first. Your other priority right now is, if you haven't already, make sure your emergency fund is padded. The general rule of thumb is 3 to 6 months of essential expenses on hand. However, depending on your situation, you may lean more harder towards the 6 months rather than the 3 months if both of you, for example, have jobs where the hours are now being reduced or one of you is out of work right now. And just a reminder, I do have a free course on my site called 5 Days to 5K. And what that is, it's a week-long course. I will walk you through the process step-by-step of how to find, save, and make some extra cash on the side. That way you can build up that buffer. Just head over to couplemoney.com/5K. I am by no means an expert on how things are going to play out. But judging by the news briefs and seeing what CDC is sending out, we're looking at something like at least 8 weeks. So now would be a good time to look ahead budget-wise at April and May. You want to review your budget because there's going to be shifts on certain expenses, and you want to redirect money that you previously spent on expenses like lunches out or gas for commuting and move that towards that emergency fund, your groceries, and general savings. Third, make sure your pantry is stocked. There is no need to panic and rush to the store. Instead, have a careful plan for when you do go out and take care of that. And if you need a list on what to pick or to order, I'll include a link in the show notes. And also in the show notes, I'm going to include a video chat I did with Andy Hill from Marriage, Kids, and Money over in our Thriving Families Facebook community. We go over a question from a reader on, again, how to prioritize your budget and your finances right now. And we included some of the relief programs that we're learning about for utilities and other companies that they are offering to their customers and members. For example, I just found out today that if you are a Coastal Credit Union member, they have a specific page for members to work through any hardships that you have and different programs. So that will also be included in the show notes. And then another side of the coin is, with a lot of uncertainty, some people are asking, what should I do with any savings or investments I have, like the 401k. And the advice I'm going to give, I saw Paula Pant give, which is keep your hands off of it. Kind of treat it like the advice they're giving us about not touching your face. Don't touch your 401k. You don't want fear to rule your investments. One of the most common things people tend to do when they are feeling uncertain is to pull out that money. But if you look at the historical data, that's a losing proposition. Now, if you're in the position where you have the savings and you can and want to invest more to take advantage of the lower prices, that is fine, but otherwise leave it alone. Instead, try redirecting some of that energy to things that you've been having on your financial to-do list, because you can get more immediate returns from that. As always, I'm here to help. If you ever have any questions, please reach out to me. I'm at Couple Money for social media. Or, like I mentioned before, you can join our free and private Facebook group, Thriving Families. All of us are focused on helping one another out. And finally, thank you so much for listening. I appreciate your support on the podcast. And I also want to remind you that there are fantastic podcasts out there that focuses on different aspects on how you can get better with your money. And one that I want to mention, you heard her earlier this week, Jen Hemphill. She has an incredible show, Her Dinero Matters. One of the things I love about Jen, and you heard earlier this week, is that she not only focuses on the practical, she's an accredited financial counselor, so she knows the technical aspects of working with your money, but she also gets into the mindset, how to communicate better and how to work on maybe those habits that we all kind of get stuck on. So please check out her podcast. It's fantastic and she's an incredible person. So if you want to get an idea and a sneak peek of who she is and what her show's about, here it is. I hope you have a wonderful week. Take care.
What is the Her Dinero Matters podcast? I am so glad you asked. It is a bilingual podcast for women who want to become reinas of their money and love their dinero more. I am your host, Jen Hemphill, a former extreme frugalist turned reina of your money advocate. And each week we go to help you rein in your money like that queen that you are with inspiring interviews and panel discussions from La Comunidad Latina and with solo episodes sharing simple, actionable tips and strategies. Plus, as a Himalaya listener, we have the Cafecito Lounge experience. In the Cafecito Lounge, I help you take your weekly experience on the podcast by a level deeper by providing you a space to chat, ask questions, take action, and go deeper on your own financial journey for only $7.99 a month. What do you get for this amount of money? You get special access to a community of like-minded women for a deeper discussion on the latest episode, monthly bonus mini episodes that give you that extra dose of confidence, answering your questions, giving you behind-the-scenes content, and extra tips. All of that. Anything you want, pretty much ask, and probably I will do a mini episode on that. Plus, you will have office hours with me to ask your pressing money questions, as well as a monthly PDF worksheet for that month's money challenge. All you have to do is click the Become a Member button and follow the prompts, and I will see you in the Cafecito Lounge.